Well, here we are again, another backcountry adventure. This is just a quick one. It's a one-nighter, and I'm trying something. Well, I'm doing a few things that I don't normally do. You probably can already tell. I'm on an inflatable paddleboard, but it's not just an inflatable paddleboard. It's the Isle Switch Pro. It's the new version of the Isle Switch, which I reviewed a couple of years ago. I actually gave it a Paddle TV award. There's a few changes. I won't talk about that right now, but I loved this board before because you can quickly move from it being a kayak to a stand-up paddleboard. A stand-up paddling camping trip is something I've never done before. And so here we go, giving it a whirl, and I'm sure there's gonna be some lessons to learn there. But I'm also trying something that this board, the Switch, does, which is it has an adapter for a motor. And so I've got the Bixby motor on here. And so I'm going for a little motorized tour, looking for some fishing spots. This is really, for me, I'm going fishing. I'm hoping to catch dinner tonight, hoping to catch a walleye. It's gonna be tricky today because we just got a ton of water, and that always makes fishing a little tricky when you get a lot of water. We got a lot of rain, and the river just came up 6 vertical feet. And that's not all because of rain, that's because of the dams releasing water too, but whenever the river level comes up that much, it messes around with the fish, they get confused, and so hopefully it doesn't completely shut them down. But this whole traveling while not paddling thing is kind of nice. The clouds are rolling in and it's supposed to start raining a little bit, not too hard this evening, but can't let the rain keep you from getting out in the water and going on a camping trip. So here we go. Hi, buddy. Small little guy. So cute. Fish on. Oh, nice little bass. Well, that's a good sign. That's a great sign. It's not gonna win any awards, but she sure is pretty. Woo-wee. That's actually a great sign. There be fish. Then again, the way fishing goes sometimes is you catch a fish right off the bat and you think, oh, the fishing's gonna be amazing. And then that's the last fish you see. This is my first time fishing from a stand-up paddleboard. Fine with fishing more than pretty much any paddling activity. When you hop into a different boat and do it, it takes a while to figure out your system for managing gear. And it feels a little awkward until you've dialed that system in. Hey, buddy. Love seeing dragonflies. Really little guy. Of all the times for me to test a motor on a paddlecraft, this is definitely the time. I was playing volleyball with my daughter. Well, it was a while ago, about 8 weeks ago, that I did it, and I was spiking it. Oh yeah, okay, maybe it wasn't that great, but I just tweaked something in my shoulder. And it's been nagging, just bothering me ever since then. And then I just finished a week-long, pretty epic trip down the Petawawa River. Stay tuned for that video, because wow, what a trip. But it was really taxing on the body. And My shoulder has just been bothering me, and I've taken 5 days off, no paddling, no exercise, no biking, nothing that involves the shoulder. And so this trip itself, I was like, but the motor is perfect. That spot looks totally worth hitting. Let's go over there. Bixby, take me there. I wonder how deep it is here. Let's see. I'm gonna try jigging. Very shallow. There we go. Fish on. Little guy. Woo. Look at that. Oh. Not exactly a monster, but nice. There's fish in here. I'm glad that first one, the one I caught right off the bat, wasn't one of those one and done situations. Nice. That's a better one, not a huge one. Come here, there we go. They're getting bigger each time, so maybe the next one will be a true monster. Oh yeah. Sweet. Well, you might recognize this camp because I have been here before, but I'm not telling you where it is because I discovered it about 8 months ago, and it was on a fateful trip where I had to swim after my kayak. It was almost winter time, and I learned a valuable lesson about cold water, dry suits, and pulling your boat up on shore. I found this campsite, and it's just awesome. And it's this little secluded spot. It's got a beautiful rock shelf to hang out on. It's got a fire ring. It's even got a table built in, which is really convenient. The only thing it has now that it didn't have 8 months ago is mosquitoes, and lots of them. So I'm gonna get some long pants and shirt on and get going with camp. I am doing it again. I'm going for the hammock. This is the second time ever sleeping in a hammock. First time was only 2 months ago, and I loved it. It was really nice. I'm ready for it now. Nice cover right here. Well, I might as well use this opportunity to get the hammock set up. I'm actually testing a couple of new products tonight, both Big Agnes, the Boundary Deluxe insulated sleeping mattress and the Lost Ranger 3-in-1 sleeping bag. Both look pretty cool, but there's only one way to find out. Well, I'm definitely glad I got the hammock and tarp up when I did. If I was any later, I'd be fine, but putting stuff up when it's raining versus before it's raining, two very different things. I've been spending so much more time camping these days, and it's funny how you get into a rhythm and everything becomes easier. You don't have to think things through as much. That, you know, I think that's why now that I'm in a rhythm with these backcountry trips and camping this year, it's really fun to try new things, try new watercraft, new gear, new sleeping systems, new cooking systems. And at some point this season, I'll definitely be doing some reviews of the non-paddling gear that I've been playing around with, because I'm definitely learning things I like and don't like. Now I'm trying different stuff and realizing, oh, hey, that's really smart. So anyway, it's been fun. See, I told you I didn't always do dehydrated meals. Okay, this isn't exactly camp cooking, this is leftovers, but I cook this at home. I do cook. Oh yeah. Do I call it a night after this, or do I get a fire going? Fire would be nice, but I don't know how long I'd really be hanging out with these bugs, even with a bug shirt. This caps off a really good week. My daughter graduated from grade 8. She had her big graduation last night. It was awesome. She's doing so well. But now she's moving from this pretty small school in our small town of Beechburg to a big school, a high school, with about, geez, probably 7 times the number of kids. So it'll be a whole different experience for her. School's pretty much done. That means I'll have to drag her out for one of these trips. I'm looking forward to it more than she's probably looking forward to it.
Bugs, mosquitoes, eh?
You were waiting for the rain to stop too, weren't you? Well, I felt a little guilty at first about not having a campfire, but man, the mosquitoes just came out in force and I'm literally hiding in the hammock, but timing's great. I'm tired. It's a good day. It's time to say goodnight. It's a good night. Very different morning today than last night. Blue skies, and a bit of a wind, a cool wind. Don't know if there is mist on the water this morning because, well, I didn't come close to getting up for sunrise. I was asleep to the world. That was a fantastic sleep. I like the hammock camping. Stuff's like rocket fuel. Well, I'm gonna start getting packed up and start fishing my way home. How are we doing for battery? Oh my gosh, I almost have the full battery after yesterday. Sweet. I think I'm gonna head down that way. There's a rapid that's a pretty cool rapid from what I remember. It's been over, probably over 10 years since I've seen it, but I can even hear it in the distance. So I'm gonna go check that out. There probably will be some eddies along the way that I can fish. That seems like a good place to start the day. That's a good size drop. Bigger than I remember it too. Definitely don't wanna go over this drop in this craft with all this gear. Very cool. And I'll bet you there's some good fishing in those holes down below. But that's not happening. Be reasonable, Ken. See if we can catch a fish in here. What is that? Is that a little creek? Interesting. Is there water going down here? I'm gonna have to explore this. Oh, this is cool. Well, it is a creek, but this is not the time of year for it. Definitely an early spring creek. I love little nooks like this, though. That's a great thing about high water too, because the waters jump so high, you can get into these spots that you normally can't. Pretty. Well, can't go any further downstream, so onward. Up we go. Well, definitely a few things I've already learned about stand-up paddle board fishing and stand-up paddle board camping. On the camping side, it's a lot more like a canoe than a kayak. You just have so much space and so much capacity. I mean, I think the capacity for this boat, or this board, boat, whatever you want to call it, is it's around 400 pounds. And so I'm really not noticing the extra weight of my gear on it at all. It doesn't perform any differently. But on top of that, I have pretty much everything in one big dry bag like I would in a canoe. And that's really nice, rather than a kayak where you have to usually have lots of little dry bags, and anytime you're moving gear around, it's all these little pieces to deal with. And if you have to portage, it's a pain in the butt. So it's really nice for camping, and surprising capacity, and have single big bags to keep things together. And if I did have to portage, which I don't have to on this trip, I mean, the board itself, even with the motor mount, it's like 20 pounds. Super light, way lighter than a kayak, way lighter than even a super lightweight canoe. So yeah, very versatile as a camping platform. For fishing, it's also great. I haven't even stood up and fished yet. I don't even know if I'm gonna, because I'm pretty comfy sitting here. The seat on this thing is like sitting on air, so I'm happy sitting down. But one thing I do notice, and you know, a paddle board versus a fishing kayak, is there's no sidewalls to this thing. So anything I put on the deck, if I tilt the board on edge or if it something rolls, it's going right off. And so you have to be a bit more careful with your gear. You can lose stuff, tie stuff in, but you know, that's just something you just have to be aware of. All right, there's no fish here. I'm surprised. But just means I have to move on. R2, take me that way. Okay, give it a bit of juice here. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Some pretty strong current here. I am gonna have to put it into overdrive to get up here. Or I'm actually gonna have to paddle. Is it deep enough? Woo! Whoa! Hit bottom. It's probably a sign. Don't go that way. Well, I gave it my best shot. Of course, I could pull up the motor and just paddle up there, but that isn't the theme of this trip. The theme of this trip is minimize exertion. It's okay to do that every once in a while. I'm perfectly fine with that. You know what? I'm actually here to fish too, and this looks like a good spot. What I like about this lure is it's kind of a surprise lure. It'll catch, there you go, surprise. I was just gonna say, catch bass, but it's also a pike catcher, but look at the size of that pike. Oh my gosh, that thing is almost the size of the lure. That's hilarious. Oh, you go free, buddy. You go free. That's a pretty fish. There you go. See you, buddy. Yeah, first pike. That is what you catch a lot here on spoons like this. And that is actually, that's why I'm using this wire leader, because you can catch some big pike here. I mean, I've caught plenty of double-digit pike up to 20 pounds, which is a fun fight. And you're not expecting it either, and all of a sudden, bam, game on. You've got, they're almost like small alligators. Ooh, just saw a fish hit the surface over there, probably bass. That's a good sign. Caught a little fish and then see a little bit of activity. Let's see what happens here. Ooh, that was a fish. As soon as it landed. Oh, don't drift into it. Very shallow. It's probably a little guy. You can hardly get it in its mouth. There we go. A little bass. Came here. Don't do that. There we go. Ooh. Oh yeah. It's got some pull. Wow. What are you, a big pike? No, it's a nice bass. No, it's a catfish. Of course it's a catfish. You little scumbag. Well, that is not exactly what I was after, but it's still a fun fish. Taking a little break. I found this sucker here. It's in the, well, along with the tuna. I was looking at, grab a can of tuna to make a little tuna salad. And they have pre-made tuna salads. This one is tuna with couscous, chickpeas, peas, and tomatoes. And it costs like $4, about the same as a can of tuna. And you don't need a can opener. Yes, I'm a sucker for simplicity. It is time for me to start making my way back. So I got a bit of current to fight on the way home. I'm not gonna be doing too much of the fighting, but I will have to do some of it because I'm pretty sure this battery won't last the whole way. It's pretty strong current, and the battery goes much quicker the higher you run it. Actually, that's pretty strong right there. I don't even know if I can get up there. Side channel, maybe? Well, let's try it. Not much choice, got to go right up the pipe. Yeah, ferry, that's what I'll do. I'll ferry to the other side. It's a little milder current up there. And then ferry back. Oh yeah, this is gonna work just fine. Nice. Wow, it is windy. Headwind too. Headwind and current, this would have been a battle right now. With this board and my shoulder, this would have been a bad idea. That's what it would have been. A little shallow up there. Stick to the deep stuff. So motors, you know, there is definitely a debate about whether motors have a place on paddlecraft. I mean, they're paddlecraft for many people means human powered boat. And so the idea of putting an electric motor on a kayak, canoe, stand, a paddleboard, what have you. For some people, it's just like, it's a hard no. It doesn't belong at all. There's very few things that I'm a hard no on. You know, it's the same as when I do gear reviews, when I review boats, there are very few boats where I'm like, hey, no, this is a bad boat. This doesn't make sense for anyone to have. It's more a question of who and in what circumstance is it the right choice. And it's totally the same thing with motors. You know, a motor for some people, it can be the only way they get on the water. And I mean, who am I, who is anyone to say that it's not the right thing to do? No. But it definitely goes beyond that. It's a really practical thing in a lot of situations. You used to use a motor fairly frequently when I was filming a fishing show. It just allowed me to move around and to get shots while on the move, much like a pedal kayak, but with a lot more control than a pedal kayak. And so that was great for that. So filming, photography, a motor makes a lot of sense. But like right now, the motor makes a lot of sense for me right now because I got a bum shoulder. I wouldn't have done this trip if I didn't have some kind of assistance like this. And so, gosh, I'm really glad I have the motor so that I could do this, because this was a blast. But there's another layer as well. And what if I had done this to my shoulder? What if I threw my back while I was out there? Just because you have a motor on your craft, your stand-up paddleboard or canoe, kayak, canoe, whatever, doesn't mean you have to use it. It can be a backup, almost you could call it a safety mechanism in case something happens. In particular, when you're on a solo trip, for me, if something happens out there, I'm in a place with a lot of current, I need to be able to paddle aggressively. If I can't paddle aggressively, I need help, because I'm not gonna get out of here otherwise. And so there's a real element of safety with the motor too. So going back to the original question, are motors appropriate for paddlecraft? Absolutely, for the right person, in the right circumstance, I have zero problems with electric motors on boats. I think they can be wonderful things. And yeah, I think that's really all I have to say about it. There's no right or wrong. I'm pretty happy I have one right now. This trip simply would not have happened without it. So thanks, Bixby. Well, that's gonna do it for me. I'm back on the main river. I mean, part of the river where there's really a lot of current. I think the water's come up since yesterday even. So not a lot of fishing to be had from here back to my vehicle. Hope you have enjoyed this adventure. I certainly have enjoyed doing something new. I always enjoy doing new things. That's what keeps things fresh for me. And I would encourage you, try something new. I remember when I started paddling, I started as a whitewater kayaker. And for the first 10 years, that's all. That's all I wanted to do. And there's nothing wrong with that. I was obsessed with it, and that's all I wanted to do, and that's fine. But I started canoeing and sea kayaking. I started trying different things, and a whole new world opened up to me. And so I'm gonna keep trying new things. I encourage you to do the same. And otherwise, stay tuned for a lot more paddling tips, paddling gear reviews, and paddling adventures. Leave a comment down below with your thoughts about motors on paddlecraft. I don't know if I should have said that, but yes, leave a comment down below. Let's have that discussion about motors and paddling.